wasn't the season Hawkeye fans had hoped for. That's putting it mildly. You come into this season with a veteran quarterback, a mammoth offensive line, a ton of running backs, a lot of experience at key places, and a really favorable schedule that doesn't include Michigan, Michigan State, Penn State, or Ohio State. Many saw a legitimate run of the Big Ten championship game in Indianapolis, but we all know that's not how it panned out. So today is a chance to at least end on a positive note. The Hawkeyes in a January 2nd bowl game facing a 6-6 Tennessee team in the Tax Slayer Bowl. First half, Vols up early and often. Jalen Hurd right up the middle. Terrible Iowa tackling. Hurd goes into the touchdown, and it is 14-0 Vols. Later, 21-0. Hurt, you can hardly watch. Joshua Dobbs, a star-making performance today, shaking off tackles and weaving his way to the end zone. It was 28-0 Tennessee in the second quarter. The Vol cheerleaders getting plenty of exercise. Back came the Hawks a little bit. Mark Wiseman on the doorstep, gets over the goal line, barely touchdown. Iowa's on the board 28-7, but at that point, it was all Tennessee once more. The Hawks got a couple of cosmetic touchdowns late, but they get thumped in this one, 45-28 the final. Iowa run out of the Tax Slayer Bowl. Tony Seaman, live in Jacksonville. You've had a chance to be around, obviously, some dejected Hawkeyes at this point, Tony. What are they saying about how this thing turned out?
Here in Jacksonville, and there are a lot of disappointed Hawkeye fans in Jacksonville. Tennessee, the Tax Slayer Bowl champions, and they really had this one from the jump of the gun. They scored in the opening drive. Iowa just could not respond. Tennessee had the lead the entire game. Their offense was clicking. Iowa's defense just was pretty much letting Tennessee do whatever they wanted. Like you said, they did get a few late touchdowns to make the score look a little better, but this game was all Tennessee. Right now, Kirk Ferentz and players are talking to the media as we speak, so we'll have those words tonight at 10. I just got a message, though, that Kirk Ferentz was asked about being fired. His response, "I'm focusing on improving my team. I don't take stock in talks about being fired." Certainly a lot of interesting things coming up, and we'll have those for you tonight at 10.